Welcome to the Bobcat News with your anchors, Dylan Hillscamp and Claire Lane.
Hi, I'm Claire and today is the 30th of October.
Hi, I'm Dylan. Let's start with a sports trivia question. How many Super Bowls have been played? A, 33, B, 86, C, 49, or D, none of the above?
I think that it is C, 49.
We will have the answer for you later.
Lately, I've been noticing some arguments in Foursquare. Also, a lot of kids want to do the maze, and others are using it for Foursquare. Miss Lloyd spoke with Ben about some of the problems and what we can do.
Hi, I'm Ben, and I'm out here with Mrs. Lloyd to ask her about Foursquare. Here are some questions. What are students doing this year with Foursquare?
You know, Ben, I think Foursquare this year is kind of hit or miss. We definitely have some problems that we'll talk about, but overall, I think kids are having fun, and we've even had some new games created with our extra Foursquare courts. The mega Foursquare is going on in the maze, and I think that's just fine. I do think kids want to remember that if kids want to do the maze like a maze, then maybe we should have some compromise, and if they can't do it for one recess, for Foursquare, because Foursquare is going on, maybe they should do it at the next recess. That could be a good compromise for that.
Okay, so there's one question. What is the biggest problem this year with Foursquare?
I think the biggest problem this year with Foursquare would be actually two problems, and I think the first one is sportsmanship. When you get out of the game, you need to be respectful and you need to be a good leader and you need to just go out of the game with no arguing. If you argue when you're out of the game, then you're not going to be allowed to play Foursquare anymore. You also need to make sure you're not kicking the ball or slamming the ball down or screaming in any way. You just need to be respectful of the players and get in line and you'll be back in line soon enough. The second problem, Ben, I think would be following the rules. So let's clarify the rules. There's no holding of any kind in Foursquare. You must hit the ball with an open hand. Spiking is allowed. And if you do not like that way of playing Foursquare, then get with a group of people and maybe designate one of the Foursquare courts as a no spiking court and just make sure everybody who comes along knows that that's the rule in that Foursquare. So no holding of any kind, hit with an open hand, and be respectful.
Thank you, Mrs. Lloyd, and kid, when you're out there at Foursquare, please remember this.
Now that it is the end of October, the students of the month have been chosen, and they are, for fourth grade, Emily, Bennett, Beau, Connor, Mackenzie, and Payson. And in fifth grade, they are Femke, Carter, Annika, Bridger, Everett, and Logan.
On Monday the 27th, all 5th grade classes went over to Squaw Creek with the Bopoja Conservation District and the Department of Environmental Quality, and they did a few activities including water testing and a game. Cole talked with Miss Stephen to find out more.
Hi, I'm Cole, and I'm here with Mrs. Stevens asking questions about the water testing program. So first of all, how did you set up the water testing program?
Well, working with the Bopoja Conservation District and the Department of Environmental Quality, we set up this day based on world water monitoring, and that's where places all over the world are checking in on the health of the streams and rivers in their communities.
Cool. What were the results of the water testing?
Well, based on some chemical tests like dissolved oxygen, turbidity, pH, based on some of those tests and the types of macroinvertebrates that we found, we can say that we have a pretty healthy stream back behind our school.
Were there any unusual results?
I think everything turned out pretty normal.
Okay. Lastly, what were the educational benefits of the program?
The kids get a lot out of this program. They get to be stewards of their own watershed and learn how to take care of it because you're the next generation that has to make sure that it's healthy for those coming after you. And they get to learn how we impact our watershed.
Cool. On Tuesday and Wednesday this week, all students went to the Lander Library to watch Halloween plays. There they enjoyed The Witch and the Scarecrow and The Frustrated Corpse. Thank you to the Lander Library for these entertaining performances.
How about we take a look at the weather with Teresa? We always enjoy it.
Hello, Bobcats. I'm your weekly weather reporter. On Monday, it will be rainy, and on Tuesday, we'll have rain with a slight chance of snow. But then on Wednesday, there's a 50% of snow, so you might want to hang up your shorts and goggles and dig out your winter coats. Get ready for a snowy day. Contradictory shirt, am I right? And on Thursday, it'll be partly cloudy, and on Friday, it'll be mostly sunny. Have a lovely week.
Sounds like a chilly week.
Remember to check the library for upcoming book clubs. And for the answer to that trivia question, if you said C-49, you are correct. Don't forget, next Friday is Donuts with Dads, so tell your dads, uncles, and grandpas to come have a donut. Have a good Halloween.
We'll let you go with some pictures from the Blazing Bobcat Swimming Reward. Good day and good news.
I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade. He'd let us in, knows where we've been in his octopus's garden in the shade. I'd ask my friends to come and see an octopus's garden with me. I'd like to be under the sea in an octopus's garden in the shade.